coming up on One Championship's Unstoppable Dreams. In a One Super Series Muay Thai bout, we have a flyweight contest between WBC Muay Thai Super Bantamweight World Champion from Italy, Joseph Lasiri, and Lumpini and WMC Muay Thai World Champion from Thailand, Singthongnoi Portalagun. Then, a lightweight contest between Chechen Jiu-Jitsu and Combat Sambo Champion from Russia, Russell Yakyayev, and former One Lightweight World Champion from Japan, Shinya Aoki. Finally, in the main event for the One Atomweight World Championship, Deep Jewels Featherweight Champion from Japan, Mei Yamaguchi, takes on One Women's Atomweight World Champion from Singapore, Angela Lee.
Welcome to the most exciting global martial arts event. It is One Championship.
Shocks the world with an upset victory. It's a world round finish for the champion. We have a new World Championship title holder. What a shocker. Quite possibly the biggest upset we've ever had in One Championship.
This is One Championship Unstoppable Dreams here at Singapore Indoor Stadium. Thailand takes on Italy in a One Super Series Muay Thai bout as Singthongnoi versus Joseph Lasiri.
Singthongnoi returns to the cage after battling his toughest opponent yet, defeating stage 3 cancer. And tonight he faces the very durable Lasiri.
If you're unfamiliar with the One Championship rule set, let's give you a reminder. One Championship Muay Thai Global rule set. 3x3 minute rounds, 10 point must system. 3 knockdowns in one round is a TKO. No throws or grappling. Let's get straight to the action. It's Italy versus Thailand. The Italian is the younger by 11 years. He's the taller by 2 centimeters. In front of a sellout crowd inside the massive Singapore Indoor Stadium. What an ovation for Singthongnoi. If you're watching live around the world to Ryder Piles in Missouri, USA, Florina Remia in Romania, Jorge Soriano in Abu Dhabi. Hope you're enjoying all the action. Lasiri, the Italian, in the white and black, goes for the outside leg kick early, circles off to his left, staying away from the power side of the southpaw Singthongnoi. There's the power early on from the back.
You can see Lasiri's got a very wide guard. His elbows are flared out. That's gonna open up his body to a lot of leg kicks or body kicks.
Oh, the big right hand! That's a knockdown! Smack back on the kisser! And the Italian doing a quick count of his teeth. Remember, 3 knockdowns in one round. 3 knockdowns in one round, and the match is over. That's number one. Singthongnoi, a house on fire early. And look at him come forward. These 4 ounce gloves here for Singthongnoi and Lasiri for the first time ever. Gut munching knee from the Italian. Catches the roundhouse kick. There's a counter from Singthongnoi. Lasiri tried to sweep out the support leg. Lasiri has to commit when he comes forward. He can't stop halfway and find himself in no man's land. There's a good hook from the Italian.
You can see both these athletes coming out tremendously fast for a first round of a Muay Thai contest.
Lasiri trying for the combinations, goes upstairs. Singthongnoi hooks on a straight left, a high left roundhouse kick. Thought about the teeth kick, does so off the back leg. Uppercut elbow from the Thai. Lasiri did not want to engage in the Muay Thai clinch with Singthongnoi.
The small gloves have got to change the clinch game. You get so much more control to be able to control your opponent's head with those small gloves.
Double roundhouse kick for the rib cage there from Singthongnoi. Double forearms down from Lasiri. Beautiful dunk from the Thai. Singthongnoi establishing his dominance early. Now, of course, a dump is when you throw your opponent to the canvas. It's not considered a knockdown, folks. It's a dump. It does mean that the opponent has to pick themselves up off the canvas. It is mentally, but more so psychologically, deflating. And at the moment, Singthongnoi, house on fire, all out aggression, hunting for the knockout.
And you can see the pressure that Singthongnoi is applying. The way he's framing off and he stepped in with that beautiful elbow.
Singthongnoi giving a lesson, Muay Thai 101 to a 2-time Muay Thai world champion. Back elbow there from Lasiri. Now they tie up and referee Onari breaks them.
You can just see the damage caused by that elbow from Lasiri. But there is no quitting this kid. He's got so much heart. He is so tough. We saw that in the Sam A match. He just continually pushed forward.
This is a different Lasiri than we saw against Sam A. This is a more gutsy, a more determined Lasiri. And Singh Tenor not phased. He's had worse cuts in shaving. Listen, the crowd give it up for Singh Tenor Portalagun. The man who defeated cancer has been rampaging in this opening round.
Man, the elbow that did the damage was so beautiful. The way that Singh Tenor framed off Lasiri, put his hand on his throat, and then just stepped in for a beautiful left elbow. And that's what opened up Lasiri there.
Big hello to Jolbin Arara, watching from Taiwan, to Moises Agosto from Providence, Rhode Island in the USA. Sandy Nye watching from the Netherlands. Aini Shinzui from Taiwan. Also Russell Salentes Siligan from Taiwan. Wherever you're watching live, 138 countries around the world. Also live on Facebook, live on Twitter, live on the One Championship app. We hope you're enjoying our prelim card from the sold-out Singapore Indoor Stadium. And Lasiri bounds back to center cage, eager to get on with it. And Singh Tenor backs him up, throws a left roundhouse kick, doubles up in it. Will he go in triplicate? Yes, he does. Goes down to the left. Double jab, left hook, crossing elbow, the big
cover. Wow, the way he closes distance and sets in those elbows.
Second knockdown of the round, one more and it's all over. Lasiri needs to survive another 10 seconds, I believe. Singh Tenor comes forward again, and there it is, end of the round. Now, don't forget, folks, that's two knockdowns already against Lasiri. Four knockdowns over the course of the match, and it's over. We move ahead to the second round.
Go!
I don't think this one goes another 3 minutes. The way Singh Tenor looked in that first round, he is here to make a big statement indeed in his comeback. Cracking roundhouse kicks to the forearm. Now, what that'll do is cause Lasiri to drop his arms once they tire, once they get hurt, and that'll leave his head exposed for the round kick up to the neck. Good jab there from Singh Tenor. He said with the 4 ounce gloves, he would be more powerful than ever. We saw it in the opening round. Good knees on the clinch here from Lasiri, then he breaks off.
He was trying to pivot away and create maybe a dump there, but you can just see the base of Singh Tenor. Muay Thai athletes have some of the heaviest hips. It's almost impossible to take down a 300 match veteran like that because they're so heavy in their hips.
Left hook from Lasiri, bouncing up and down high on the ball from his feet. Should have thrown the right hand for company. There it is from the Italian. High lift roundhouse kick from Singh Tenor. On the outside here, the tie. Lasiri spinning back elbow and a crossing elbow. Beautiful work there from Lasiri. And now the Italian putting on a show.
This is a much better round for Joseph Lasiri.
Lasiri's confidence is flowing here in the Lion City.
Oh man, look at his arm, Michael. It looks like a Ziploc bag full of hamburger. Those big kicks are just deadening that arm. That's gonna have effect as this match goes on.
Neither look for one man to execute a dump. No, referee Onari breaks them. What a start to this round from Lasiri.
Man, I am a fan of Joseph Lasiri. There is no quitting this kid. He is just full of heart and determination.
That cut has opened up a little more. We say a big hello to all of our fans, to those watching in Nashville, Tennessee. It's Austin Pierce. A big hello to you. And Dunley Teabunja watching from Baguio City in the Philippines. They'll be supporting all the Team Lakai athletes tonight. Look at it. Sold out more than a week ago. Singapore Indoor Stadium. It's the hottest ticket in Singapore right now. It's the place to be. Been all over the media all week. One Championship does it again. The largest martial arts organization on the planet. You're watching a One Super Series Muay Thai contest. You can watch them all live, all free, all fights on the app. Download it now.
Go!
Lasiri comes racing forwards right in the middle of the cage. Takes command of the distance.
After his outing against Sam A Gang, Hidal didn't go so well. Lasiri, you feel, has really redeemed himself here tonight. There's a house kick to the waist there from Singh Tenor. Now the tie is loading up the heavy artillery.
Sing Tong Noi's trying to finish it. He's coming forward. There's another one of those elbows again.
Two elbows. The legs almost buckled on Lesiri. They clinch up against the cage. Do a little bit of a tango. Gut-munching knee there from Lesiri. Breaks off now. Thought about the front kick that Sing Tong Noi goes with the hands to the jaw to no avail. Thrusting jab. There's the left cross over the southpaw stance of the tie. Kicks to the back leg.
The pressure of Sing Tong Noi. Look at him faking that push kick. Coming in, that's where he slides in with that elbow. He fakes the push kick, lifts the leg up, and then slides in with the elbow. Big body kick to the arm again.
Those ribs of Lesiri must be hurting. They are damaged and bruised. We do score on damage in one super series. And certainly Sing Tong Noi doing that to the forehead and to the body of Lesiri. Oh, it's off.
Joseph Lesiri, all hard.
Lesiri is devastated. He is very emotional here, but a good call, I feel, from referee Onari. Because Sing Tong Noi inflicted the damage on Lesiri. What a return for Sing Tong Noi Portalakun.
He came back, he beat stage 3 cancer, and now he beats another one of his toughest opponents, Joseph Lesiri. Look at his ass, beautiful spinning back elbow. Joseph Lesiri put on a show, throwing elbows of his own. Look at that, fakes the push kick. There's that frame, oh, big left hand. He just kept opening up that cut a little bit too much. The referee was forced to stop the contest. Sing Tong Noi comes away with another huge win to add to that already stacked resume, Michael.
Big cheerio to Billy Ackley in the United Kingdom. I know that Billy enjoyed that one, as did we. I'm sure you all did, wherever you're watching around the world. Could that be the Go Daddy knockout of the night? Let's go to Dominic Lau to make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Atsushi Onari, has put a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 36 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of technical knockout, Sing Tong Noi Portalakun!
What a return. What a message of inspiration to those battling or having battled cancer around the world. Sing Tong Noi Portalakun! A legend in the Muay Thai world makes his one Super Series debut. Coming up after the break, it's Rasul Yakyayev against Shinya Aoki. Welcome back to One Championship Unstoppable Dreams here at Singapore Indoor Stadium.
It's Japan against Russia as Shinya Aoki takes on Rasul Yakyayev.
Yakyayev burst onto the one scene with a huge upset, but can he do it again against one of the greatest grapplers Asia has ever known?
If you're unfamiliar with the One Championship rule set, let's give you a reminder. One Championship Global Rule Set. 3 by 5 minute rounds. The bout is judged in its entirety. No kicks to the head of a grounded opponent. No spiking or suplexes on the head, neck or spine. Russia versus Japan. Yakyayev is the younger of the two, but he gives up 3 centimeters in height.
It's no surprise that the grappling of Shinya Aoki is jumping off the page, but Yakyayev's gonna have a striking advantage in this one.
This one's set for 3 rounds. Inside the sold-out Singapore Indoor Stadium, where they've turned out by their thousands for One Championship Unstoppable Dreams.
Judge time. Ready? Ready?
This match brought to you by Solo, a Star Wars story in cinemas, May 2018. Shinya Aoki, former world champion, bounds out of his corner.
Shinya's looking to close the distance, slide under the punches, just like that.
Almost caught him coming in with that tagging right hand, puts Aoki against the cage. Peppering rights there from the Russian.
Good job for Yakyayev to spin him around, has a deep underhook on the left side. But Shinya Aoki flies into an armbar into an alma plata.
Not where Yakyayev wants to be. You don't want Aoki on top of you. Not this early anyway.
We were talking about the creativity, and that is a perfect example of it. beautiful. He's known for his flying triangles. He's known for his flying arm bars. And that was a beautiful transition from an arm bar into an omoplata. Now Shinya's on top, creating a lot of heavy top pressure.
One of the finest BJJ exponents in the sport, Shinya Aoki, top position on Russell Yagyayev. Where does Yagyayev go from here, Dragon?
Well, first he's got to create a little bit of space, so he's got to try to get that left arm underneath Shinya Aoki's right arm to carry a bit of an underhook. He's trying to frame off the face to do that, to create a little bit of space so he can get that in there. Hard time, but a deep, look at that. Look at the pressure. I know the squeeze. I have been on the bottom with Shinya Aoki. He is so strong. His hands look like a bunch of bananas. They're so big, and he's got so much top pressure.
Watch out your head.
Still top position here for Shinya Aoki. We are joined by world's heavyweight champion, The Truth, Brandon Vera. Brandon, great to be here. What a night in Singapore.
This is an amazing time. I've never been to the stadium here, indoor arena, and it's this crowd is live. The fights are amazing. God, thank you for having me.
It's great to have you here, champ. And we're seeing Shinya Aoki, Mitch, in control of Russell Yagyayev.
Shinya seems very comfortable just to stay here in half guard. He's not trying to pass. You can see the sort of the position that Yagyayev has, almost a lockdown position where he has the legs threaded under, but Shinya's trying. Now he's trying to pass. He's trying to slide the knee up, trying to get through. Yagyayev made his debut in one championship and looked real good against Shannon Wierichai. Put on a very impressive game plan. So I hope that transitions here and he can figure out a way to get out of this heavy top pressure from Shinya Aoki.
Brandon, if you're in the corner of Yagyayev, what are you telling the Russian to do here off his back?
He needs to get that pressure off of his chest, get his back up on the fence, wall walk, and get up so he's not underneath Shinya. This is the worst position for him to be in.
Aoki looking to take on those in an omoplata there, Mitch.
Beautiful transition into a triangle. Got the mount from the triangle position. Has it deep, but Yagyayev's trying to punch his way out of it. But as he's doing that, Shinya's adjusting. He's taking the punches to get that triangle even tighter.
I thought we may have seen a more passive Aoki tonight, but he has brought the grappling aggression early on here. Look at this triangle.
Oh,
Yagyayev in all sorts of bother.
One bar on the right side, Michael.
Oh, it's good.
Was a double threat right there. Had the triangle, got tighter and tighter as Yagyayev was trying to punch his way out, but then caught him in a straight arm lock and got the arm bar finish. That is impressive. That is classic Aoki. Two submissions in one.
Brandon Vera, we've seen two guys back to back who want to crack at the lightweight championship again. Edward Flying and now Shinya Aoki. That was classic.
That would be a beautiful matchup. Classic striker versus the ground guy. This submission, like you said, the 2-for-1 package that he gave him was perfect. You couldn't ask for anybody to be more calm, collected, and cool in there during the match.
What an aggressive opening round from Aoki, back and doing it big time.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has put a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 15 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of triangle choke, Shinya Aoki!
Shinya Aoki brings the house down in Singapore. Another submission of the highest order from a man who can do them the very best, and he can do them all. Coming up after the break, it's Mei Yamaguchi against Angela Lee. Welcome back to One Championship Unstoppable Dreams here at Singapore Indoor Stadium. It's the rematch the world's been waiting for the one atomweight world championship between Angela Lee and Mei Yamaguchi.
Unstoppable Angela Lee has shown improved striking, but the ground game is truly where she excels. If Yamaguchi wants to take the belt off of Lee in Singapore, she'll need to take her game to the next level.
I lost my mother when I was 9 years old. My father and my stepmother took care of me and my sister. I didn't have everything. It was pretty hard. One thing is that I had karate. I think that's the place I would go and be myself. If the opponent had looked that they have good family, good support, I feel like I can't never defeat. The situation always pushes me. It gives me the never give up spirit. It always gave me power to go through. When I was a kid, I didn't realize it, but I had a place to stay. I had people who's watching me. That's the important thing. That's why I'm able to be here. I hope she was here watching me, but I always believe that she's with me all the time. She's watching me from heaven. I think my mother will be very happy about it.
Mei Yamaguchi makes her way along the hallway of champions here in Singapore. The rematch she and the world have been waiting for is finally upon us. Mei Yamaguchi says she has finally solved the riddle to stop unstoppable Angela Lee. The warrior and Angela Lee has helped the one atomweight world champion overcome a traumatic experience. It left him, Angela Lee, emotionally distraught. She comes back tonight after that terrible accident.
It's crazy because things can just happen that fast in the blink of an eye, in a split second. I think that the accident was a big wake-up call for everyone, for me, for my family, and really just shook everything up. I still get emotional thinking about it and talking about it because sometimes you're just used to being strong all the time and having to put up this face like to the world that everything is okay. But sometimes it's just not. I couldn't even like step on the mat without like crying. But with the support from my family, like everyone banded together, because like my family, they say like when one person is weak, then everyone else has to be strong to help lift them up. And that's what happened, that's what we did. And through this journey, I got that fire back, my passion, my purpose. I'm so ready, I'm so excited just to get out there again. So you're gonna see the best version of me.
As Japan versus Singapore, Mei Yamaguchi, 14 years the older, gives up 10 centimeters in height.
Both these young ladies are Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belts, but a slight grappling advantage goes to the champion, Angela Lee.
The rematch the entire world has been waiting for. In front of a sellout crowd, the Singapore Indoor Stadium. The moments before, and Angela Lee back. There's nothing quite like it. This one brought to you by Grab, Southeast Asia's leading online to offline mobile platform. Titan reach to Angela Lee. Remember last time they battled, Mei Yamaguchi dropped Angela Lee. It was arguably the greatest women's martial arts bout ever. Nice stiff lead hand there from Lee. Good punching combination, 3-2 combo from Lee. Yamaguchi, wily, cagey, and powerful. It's the early get-go, Mitch, but already are we seeing improved striking as Angela Lee said she had?
Yeah, Angela Lee showed great punching technique, great ring generalship, moving around very strong against Jenny Huang. Picked Jenny Huang apart, has improved by leaps and bounds. You can see her immediately take the center of the cage, really trying to find her distance right now. She's utilizing leg kicks, but she's really just dictating exactly where this bout is being contested.
Remember, Mei Yamaguchi said she wanted to go to the body. There you saw a right hand to the stomach.
That's where she wants to soften up Angela Lee. Go the liver, go the stomach, go the ribs. Expect the hands will fall, then go the head for the knockout. Angela presses her against the cage.
She's kind of staying at Angela's distance. You know, she's got the, Angela's able to land leg kicks, pulling out the jab. Mei Yamaguchi's got to close the distance. She's got to stay nice and tight, get into boxing range, go to the head, go to the body.
Beautiful knee, almost folded her in half like origami. Angela keeps her pressed against the wire. Yamaguchi trying to fire a right hand. More knees from the champion.
Ooh, nice elbow.
You can hear Angela grunting behind these elbows, Mitch.
Very easy. She's framing off with the left hand, and she's creating just enough space to sneak that left elbow in.
Still got the overhook on that. Left arm of Yamaguchi drills another knee to the midsection. It's Lee tendering the body of Mei Yamaguchi, not the other way around. Some Muay Thai, the elbow from Angela Lee, outside leg kick from the champion. Striking, looking on point so far for Angela Lee. And now presses VV Yamaguchi against the cage again.
Yamaguchi's got the underhook on that side, so she could probably spin around. Angela Lee was threatening to go on the inside trip there.
Chance for the knees, wide open midsection. Angela catches her. Good counter right hand and break off from Yamaguchi. Oh, straight right hand, smack bang to the jaw there from Yamaguchi. Angela follows her. Yamaguchi drifting counterclockwise. Nice little pirouette from the Japanese martial artist.
That's what I like. I'd like to see her throw the hands, move outside, and come right back in with some more.
Jab two falls short for Yamaguchi. Needs to get on the inside. Does so. There's an overhand right. Angela high on the balls of her feet. Yamaguchi threw the overhand right again. There's a bolo punch. Nice fake and straight line boxing from Angela Lee. Succulent striking combinations from the champion. 120 to go, first round of fight. Overhand right across the head back of Angela. Nice work from Mei Yamaguchi.
Like
she found range in the opening contest with that overhand right, Mitch.
Yeah, you can see her jab to the body and then immediately come up over the top with that overhand right.
1 minute left in the first round.
Outside leg kick from Yamaguchi.
Because of the height advantage that Angela Lee has, she puts her in a perfect position for that overhand right.
Yamaguchi hunting for a takedown. No. Angela throws a knee again. There's the elbow. Yamaguchi threads a knee down the center. Overhook now from Angela on the left shoulder. Good curling right hand from Yamaguchi. Toe to toe here in the first round. A fantastic battle. Can Angela sit down on this choke attack?
Mei Yamaguchi pops her head out, has her pressed up against the cage. A lot of clinch work going on here, but good reversal from Angela. Look for the elbows.
Looking to slice and dice with the elbows is Angela Lee. Yamaguchi wants to break off here. Ducks under the elbow, ducks under the right elbow, counters with the right hand. Lots of lateral movement here from Mei Yamaguchi. First rounder. We move ahead to the second round.
I like how she's ending each exchange with the leg kick, but also maybe threaten a takedown. Get Mei Yamaguchi thinking about something else besides
Round two.
Angela Lee striking has looked exquisite so far. Second round of fight. Lee with it, hopping inside thigh kick. Good right hand from Yamaguchi. Outside leg kick from Angela Lee. The speed of Lee. The strides she takes with her height advantage. Cuts off the cage very quickly.
I like how she's covering distance. Mei Yamaguchi steps in. It's like a two-step little uppercut she just threw right there, and it landed.
Jab to Yamaguchi, takes the outside thigh kick, catches the front kick. Angela may be hunting for a takedown now. Trying to change it up a little, dragon.
Goes for the outside trip. Good defense from Yamaguchi. Goes after it again. Gets it. Kamei to elevate here with the butterfly hook on the right side.
They roared in the Lion City for Angela Lee. Reversal attempt here from Yamaguchi.
Nice little butterfly sweep there, but Angela was wise to it, able to recover her hips, stay on top.
Butterfly guard from Yamaguchi glances over towards her corner.
We're holding her. She's got a lot of control. She's got the arms laced over, and she's got her feet on the inside of the hips of Angela Lee, so she's gonna have a lot of movement and control. There she goes, feet on the hips now. She's extending out, but Angela's just got so much of a reach advantage. She's still able to control the posture.
This is right in front of Angela Lee's corner. Her father, her brother, her fiance giving her much needed instruction. She's inside the close guard of Mei Yamaguchi. Nice little posture up and dropping that right hand to the face of Yamaguchi. A couple of knots to the side of the head. Angela Lee, the ground and pound. She postures up. That's deafening. The roars for Angela Lee in Singapore. They love her here.
Yamaguchi's trying to off balance Angela Lee by bunking her with her hips and trying to get her body weight up over hers. She's trying to get her hips up over her hips to create a little bit of a movement so she can start attacking from the guard. But Angela Lee's got good control of the center of her gravity, and she's keeping her shoulders over her hips, which gives her better control in that position.
Angela Lee, the crowd in power! Here comes the right hand! The champion postures up, drives a hammer fist strike to the midsection. Mei Yamaguchi throws the legs up, hoping to lock up an arm. Maybe he's hooking in a triangle. Angela Lee, could she go for an armbar from here? You can see the damage that Angela's done to the outside left thigh of Yamaguchi from those leg kicks in the stand-up. What's Angela looking for here, man?
Angela's just trying to control the arms, so she's trying to threaten an armbar. She's got one leg in, the other leg's wrapped around the leg. Mei Yamaguchi has got to keep her stacked. She can't allow Angela Lee to start extending her body, which is what she's doing right now.
This is danger! This is danger!
Hold Angela Lee up. She's got the arm hyperextended. That is not what an arm is supposed to do, Michael. It's going the wrong way. But her thumb is now down to the body of Angela, so she's able to defend it.
Angela Lee hunting for a second round submission. Olivia Cox right on top of the action. And Yamaguchi's turned down. Can she posture up from the ground? Can she land some ground and pound?
I don't know how the judges are going to see that. Was it a near submission? That's right at the top of our scoring. Good heart show there by Mei Yamaguchi to grit out that armbar, because that looked pretty deep.
Mitch, any sense of deja vu, the back and forth submission attempts from both these athletes like last time?
Michael, we are right back into round 7 between two of the best female martial artists on the planet. Look at Angela trying to hunt for the arms. She's trying to trap the arms. Avoid the ground and pound. Now she's looking to swivel her hips. You can see her popping her hips out to the left and to the right, keeping her guard nice and high. Angela Lee's got a very tricky guard.
Heel kicks now from Angela Lee. Effective off of her back, controlling Mei Yamaguchi's posture. 20 seconds to go in the second round. Yamaguchi trying to yank her arms free. Does so now, lands a right hand.
Look at the grip fighting that's happening. Angela Lee is actually holding both Mei Yamaguchi's arms and then striking from the bottom.
We move ahead to the third round. 3 of 5. Angela Lee coming close to an armbar. Bounds out of her corner. Guard up high. Got to watch for the overhand right on Yamaguchi. There it is from the Japanese athlete. They know each other inside out. What a superb matchup. The rematch the entire world's been waiting for. And the hype throughout the last week or so here in Singapore reached phenomenal levels. The electricity sold out over a week ago. No standing room left here inside the stadium.
You can see Mei Yamaguchi, she darts in. You can see that karate background, how she closes the distance with her feet with some very good footwork, lands a strike, and then pops right back out.
Some damage under the left eye of Yamaguchi. Front kick there from Lee. Yamaguchi circles off counterclockwise. Lee circles to her right, slings the outside leg kick. Yamaguchi needs to start checking those. Lands one of her own.
You can see the leg kicks of Angelique are starting to redden up that left leg of Yamaguchi.
Let's talk to her right hand. 3-2 combination from Lee. Yamaguchi presses forward now. Is Lee going to go down the center? It's Yamaguchi who does that off the right hand. Overhand right from Yamaguchi. Lee saw it coming. Overhand right to a left hook.
I'd like to see Yamaguchi go to the body. Angelique's defending well on the punches to the head. When she lifts up her hands, Yamaguchi has hooks to the body.
Good high inside thigh kick there from Angela Lee. Fires out the front kick. Yamaguchi, plenty of movement. That's the right hand! Smack back! Come by Yamaguchi!
Beautiful. Caught the low kick, timed it beautifully with the straight right hand.
Gets the knee guard here, sees Angela chambering those right knees. Angela switches now. Chance for the left knee. It's Mei Yamaguchi who finds the knee. Angela hooks her.
Good wrist control by Angela Lee. She let go of it and landed a nice little two-punch combination.
Yamaguchi, four-punch combination down the center, then goes to the midsection. That's what she wanted to do, soften up the belly of Angela Lee. Yamaguchi trying to bait Angela Lee in. More straight line punches, the Shudan Tsuki technique of karate. Reverse punch, they call it. Some better flashes here from Mei Yamaguchi, staying busy. There's the overhand right again. Angela's got to keep the left hand up, the chin tucked. Look through the brow, and Yamaguchi goes back to the body. Angela Lee ties her up, back through against the cage. They throw knees.
Angela Lee is very strong in the clinch. She's won most of these exchanges. Now she's working her way around the body. Oh, goes for a beautiful inside trip, right? As Mei Yamaguchi was starting to get the better of some of the striking exchanges, the champ takes the challenger down.
How does the tide turn now on the ground? Yamaguchi back to her feet. Will Angela try to get her down again? Belly to back, reaches into the canvas.
Beautiful. Beautiful, takes the back.
The hook. The hook from Angela Lee.
Has a full 60 seconds to work from the back.
Mei defending. Angela tries to get the hooks in. Riding the back of Yamaguchi.
She's a bit high. Look for that transition to the arm bar.
40 seconds remains. Third round of five. Angela Lee in a dominant ground position. After Mei Yamaguchi had the advantage on the feet.
30 seconds left in the third round.
Still has the back of Yamaguchi. Elbows there from Angela with a collarbone. Shot to the side of the head. It is absolutely deafening here in Singapore. Angela Lee is going to try and stop her out. Can she find the finish?
Give up. Give up.
Final second, and Yamaguchi survived the round. Angela Lee takes her into the fall. It's round four after the break. Welcome back to One Championship Unstoppable Dreams here at Singapore Indoor Stadium. Look at this massive sea of Singaporeans inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium. They have turned up in their thousands for one champion. Largest organization on the planet. They call these the championship rounds. Angela high on the balls of her feet. May a little more flat-footed. Good outside leg kick to a right-hand combination from Lee. Jab to the right hand to the high kick. Overhand right from Yamaguchi. Didn't have the mustard behind it. Yamaguchi tried to get on the inside with short punching combinations. Didn't work for it. Overhand right from Yamaguchi. Yamaguchi goes to the body. I don't think she's done as much body work as you hope to do here tonight, Mitch.
Yeah, she's not really landing the effective body shot. She is kind of landing the jab to the body, but that's not going to do the damage like the left hook would. But she is going to the head, stepping off and landing shots, but they're just not doing enough damage at this point because of the ground exchanges and the ground control that Angela Lee is showing in these, like, sort of punctuate the end of each round.
Lee looking to counter off the right hand. Controlling center cage. Yamaguchi edges forward. Both women pouring. Range finder of the lead hand for Angela Lee. Yamaguchi threw the right hand. Didn't connect with it. Gotta get that distance. Gotta get that timing. Skip up front kick there from Lee. Left hook, straight right hand. Left hook again from Lee. Can she find the knee? It's an uppercut over.
Those look like they hurt Yamaguchi. She was kind of tilting away a little bit as Angela Lee landed the hook straight.
You can hear the chants going up for Angela Lee. This heavily partisan crowd fully behind their golden girl. Chance for the knees, and Lee throws it to the liver off the left.
Look for Angela Lee to try to hook the outside of the leg and drag Yamaguchi down.
Uppercut elbow off the right arm. Yamaguchi tries to thread the knee high. Lee presses her against the cage. Right knee, belly button through the back. Yamaguchi tries to break off. Lee keeps her pressed against the wire. Elbows, boxes her way out. Good stiff jab between the eyes. Yamaguchi hopes for a right hand counter. Outside leg kick to that reddened lead thigh. It looks like it's been sunburned.
It's doing a lot of damage. I like that leg kick. She throws the hands, exits with the leg kick. Slowing down the movement of Yamaguchi, especially in these final rounds.
Yamaguchi with the aggression through the right hand with bad intentions.
Yamaguchi's got to turn things up a little bit. She's got to start putting a little bit more pop into her punches, putting the pressure on Angela Lee. She especially can't let her back her up into the corner and put her back against the cage.
There's the right hand from Yamaguchi. Angela Lee on her back. She's turned around. Yamaguchi tries to look on the choke.
Yamaguchi's on top. Look at Angela. She's got that knee shield right there with the left leg. Laces her top leg over and controls the posture there.
On butterfly hook for Angela Lee. Left leg.
Elevates the body with the butterfly hook with that foot underneath her thigh and is able to she's trying to get her other leg on the inside as well.
Off the back here, the champion, Angela Lee, under a minute remaining.
You can see her trying to shove the arm through to threaten a triangle, but Mei Yamaguchi's wise to it, not letting her pop her hands out.
Very high guard now. Close guard from Angela Lee. 40 seconds on the clock. No chance for Yamaguchi to posture up at the moment. Lee closing her down, dragging her head.
Ground and pound. You can see Angela Lee's controlling the head, so Yamaguchi's not able to posture up and put a little bit more into the punches, but she is active off the ground as Angela Lee shoots for an armbar.
This crowd roaring and anticipation, but it's not there yet.
Oh, good job by Mei Yamaguchi to push down the leg and try to pass guard.
Light flowing from Yamaguchi. We are going to go into the fifth and final round, into the deepest of deep waters. Just like we did last time, we're going there again. Getting into the fifth round, how do you see the mentality of Angela Lee, all the emotion, and also seeing your brother losing a decision earlier tonight? Any effects on Angela?
I think Angela wants to make a statement now in the fifth and final round of her championship match. She wants to put it on. You can see the emotion in her face, Michael.
5 minutes remaining. A stiff right hand there from Mei Yamaguchi. Yamaguchi. Oh!
Control, but Angela Lee is able to quickly get into half guard, and she needs to stall a little bit here, get her clear mind a little bit. That could create a lot of cobwebs.
The aggressive meter off the charts at the start of this round for Mei Yamaguchi. Maybe she knows she's behind. Maybe she knows she's got to swing the pendulum. It's all for Mei Yamaguchi. She's in top position, but she's all locked up and locked out by the champion who's on her back.
You can see Angela's trying to control the posture. Mei Yamaguchi's hitting the body a little bit, but Mei Yamaguchi has to peel that head off. Angela Lee chose to let it go. Now she's in half guard. She's got to try to improve the position here.
Unstoppable Dreams has been phenomenal. Trending on Twitter in Singapore. 138 countries around the world watching the greatest martial arts action on the planet. Mei Yamaguchi, little shoulder thrust from top position. This main event, this championship match has had it all.
If that shot rocked Angela Lee, this is the time she's able to clear the cobwebs, get things right in her mind. You can see Yamaguchi's trying to improve her position, but Angela Lee's doing a good job of controlling her half guard. See there, she has the leg grapevine, and she's not allowing Mei Yamaguchi to improve her position.
Yamaguchi is still top position, and Angela closing her down, controlling her posture. Yamaguchi trying a little shoulder thrust to the jaw again. Angela.
Good job. Good little hip bump there to get back into full guard. Nice little swivel of the hips. Angela's got to create some movement here. Yamaguchi's got 3 minutes to work in the top position. Expect ground and pound, but look how much control Angela Lee has there. She's gripping the hand fighting, threatening submissions off her back and striking off her back.
How Yamaguchi would love to rain down the punches. Lee's not gonna let it happen. Past the halfway mark of this fifth and final round.
Lee's doing a good job of protecting herself, but here's a scramble. Angela Lee's trying to create a scramble here to move, and she's able to get back into half guard.
One butterfly hook there for Lee.
These are two Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belts, and they are putting on a show of grappling exchanges right now. Look at Angela Lee, hand fighting on one side, head control on the other, trying to create the sweep.
They weren't black belts last time they met. They both are now. Angela trying to throw the legs up. 1 minute 40 remains. The Singaporean crowd cheering on Angela Lee. Authority!
She's able to pop her arm out. She's not in much danger. She's able to clear the legs. Look, now Angela Lee triangles legs. There's a possible omoplata. She might be able to roll into it. Yamaguchi chooses to stack her, stay on top.
Lee transitioning from one sub-attempt to another. And now Yamaguchi wants to let those hands go. Approaching the final minute of this bout.
Yamaguchi. 1 minute left in the final round.
Little elbow to the orbital there. Hammerfist strike to the collarbone. There's a hand between the eyes. Yamaguchi popping away. Angela Lee back to her feet. I can't hear myself inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium. left arm from Angela Lee. Turned her against the cage. 30 seconds to go.
30 seconds left in the final round.
It could come down to these last 30 seconds, Michael, if one of these young ladies can do something dramatic.
Listen to them go. From Yamaguchi, doubles up with it. Angela Baxter against the wire. It was another classic.
Michael, it was too close to call. He judged it on its entirety, and look at Mei Yamaguchi, the constant off-balancing of catching the kicks. Big double leg takedown to end up in side control. Spent a majority of that round in the top position, dropping a little bit of ground and pound, but Angela was very active off her back. She wasn't only threatening submissions, but she was throwing strikes from the bottom. Here's how we ended the round as Mei Yamaguchi charges in, fights, gives it everything she has, and sticks the double leg. What an amazing, another match of the year contestant from two absolute warriors, Michael.
Chantry Sinchotong in the cage to present the championship bout. Does it go around the waist of Angela Lee? Does it go around the waist of Mei Yamaguchi? We're about to find out. It was an absolute rip snorter in Singapore. Everything we hoped for and a whole lot more. Let's go to Dominic Lau for our decision.
And now, to present the belt for this match, we have Miss Hui Ling Tan, co-founder of Grab. Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this bout in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, and still one women's atomweight world champion, Angela Lee.
And now down in Singapore, the gold reigns over the cage. Angela Lee retains the atomweight world title. Showered in gold. Incredibly emotional scenes here. Goodbye from all of us at One Championship's Unstoppable Dream here at Singapore Indoor Stadium. Join us next time for more explosive action in the cage.